When we say cybercrime, we normally think of identity fraud, hacking, and data theft. But in the last few years, a completely new type of digital crime has taken over. Deepfake, the process of replacing the face of one individual with another to produce a realistic video of events that never actually happened. But what are the educational uses of deepfake? How are deepfakes helping to broaden the horizons of the entertainment industry? And what are the malicious intentions behind some of the creators of this synthetic media? Here's how it happened. The word deepfake itself comes from deep learning, a type of artificial intelligence used to mimic brain function. Applications like Photoshop have been around for over 30 years, not to mention movie special effects, colorization, and CGI. But what makes deepfake so different is the way it can replace someone's likeness in video format, perfectly replicating the way their face moves for both speech and expressions. The technology was first used in academic study during the late 90s in the Video Rewrite Project, which, although not appearing 100% realistic, demonstrated how the practice could work. A group of researchers from Germany and Stanford University later undertook a project called Face to Face in 2016, posting a YouTube video explaining how their technology worked and showing how realistic their deepfakes could be, using Presidents George W. Bush and Donald Trump as their targets. A year later, another video went even more viral, this time starring an artificial Barack Obama making a speech in his own voice, but taken from a different image. Many were excited by the technology on display, but there were fears that it could also be misused and act as a catalyst for the fake news pandemic that was starting to spread. The term deepfake then began to grow in popularity across Reddit, with amateur editors posting comical content like Nicolas Cage's face imposed on different scenes from various movies, as well as darker clips, sometimes pornography, but using the face of a famous celebrity. In 2018, researchers from the University of California, Berkeley found they were able to extend the technology to full body movements, publishing a paper that introduced a fake dancing app that could seemingly give expert dancing ability to any individual. As the technology continued to improve, deepfake has been taken on by bigger and more prestigious companies, such as in Channel 4's alternative Queen's Speech and Microsoft's acquisition of Seeing AI, an application that uses some of the features of deepfake to narrate surroundings to blind users. Details could include text on signs and documents, recognizing emotions of others, or identifying products on store shelves, all in a range of languages. More recently, audio deepfakes have also been produced, perfectly copying the target's voice based on as little as 5 seconds of listening time, while the clumsy dubbing of Hollywood films could soon be a thing of the past, as the latest technology allows the likes of Jack Nicholson and Tom Hanks to appear completely fluent in foreign languages, with their lips synchronizing to match the new audio.
C'est amusant, monsieur.
Non, au contraire. C'est tragique.
Avez-vous réponse à ça?
Absolument.
But sadly, deepfakes have been making headlines for as many of the wrong reasons as the right ones. Social media platforms Facebook and Twitter have said they are cracking down on deepfakes to stop the spread of disinformation, and are working on their own technology to improve their detection rate. And as mentioned earlier, deepfake pornography is also a fast-growing social problem, with Reddit deleting its deepfake subreddit and celebrities such as Scarlett Johansson speaking out on the issue, identifying the potential for blackmail and abuse as a result of the technology. Authorities in the US, UK, and Canada have described non-consensual deepfakes as harassment in the eyes of the law, and are looking into creating legislation that specifies the practice by name. Let us know your thoughts and whether you think deepfake will be for the better or worse for society. And that's how it happened. Thanks for watching.